New Mexico notched a win in the water war with Texas this past week. The Supreme Court said the state should get credit for water that evaporated in New Mexico after Texas asked our state to hold that water to prevent flooding. Texas argued it was still owed some 21,000 acre feet. Interesting decision there. Serge, why is this a significant decision in your opinion?
Well, I mean, this is, I think, an interesting opinion. It may not have a lot of precedential value or significance going down the road for a few reasons. One, my colleague Reed Benson is an expert in these matters, and he has a really interesting piece on this on the Supreme Court blog, SCOTUS blog, that he writes for. But, you know, basically, this was a dispute between New Mexico and Texas about whether the river master, who had been appointed, you know, many years ago, could resolve a dispute about what happened when New Mexico was storing water for Texas that, at Texas's request, that evaporated between, you know, the time of that request and the time of delivery. And when the river master made a determination that Texas didn't like, they took this case, you know, up to the Supreme Court, which the reason it was at the Supreme Court is because that's where you go when one state sues another. And I think it was interesting that, and this is twice in one week, that Texas was on the wrong end of a decision by the Supreme Court when it was suing other states. You know, these things don't happen all that often. But in terms of, you know, what this means going down the road, you know, there's only two river masters in the country. We have one.
Right.
But it does probably mean that Texas and New Mexico will be have more incentive to try to work future disputes, and I'm sure there are many more coming out amongst themselves, between each other, right, rather than go up to the Supreme Court, which clearly didn't want to have anything to do with the underlying, you know, matter.
Senator, you know, interestingly, when I consider this, thinking about it last night, I mean, Texas asked us to hold the water. We held the water. And then they claimed we didn't deliver. I mean, you could call it cheeky. I think there's another word there. I mean, this ask is really kind of interesting to me. Were you surprised? Are you surprised at the decision?
Well, I'm always glad when New Mexico wins over Texas.
Good point.
And we've had water disputes and cases with Texas before, in El Paso, for example, in 1979, and we lost. And Texas won. The conventional wisdom is that Texas is always going to out-lawyer us, throw more money at us, at the case. And really, I mean, it's the Rio Grande that is the big kahuna.
That's
here,
right.
Or maybe the big trout, big brown trout, because these are interstate compacts. And the Rio Grande compact has been strained by drought and climate change. And the obligations that New Mexico has to Texas are hard to meet in those conditions. And so there are some that say that the Rio Grande Compact really needs to be renegotiated altogether so that Colorado, New Mexico, and Texas have a more realistic share of a limited water supply. And that's not going to happen anytime soon.
Right.
So meanwhile, New Mexico's under the gun from Texas, especially on the Rio Grande.
Merritt, this decision was for the Pecos River, but as Dee Dee just mentioned, the Rio Grande's a whole other kettle of fish here. When you think about the still pending suit about groundwater pumping for farmers south of Elephant Butte on the Rio Grande, there's a lot here that needs to be parsed out, and I'm curious what you guys think about how Senator Feldman just set this up. In a time of drought and everything else, do we have a chance to revisit any of this and really fight this out in a fair way?
I guess what really struck me about the case that was just adjudicated was the key element. Texas had just been inundated by a tropical storm.
Right.
You know, Texas has been flooding, so that's why we were asked to store the water. So I also try to imagine the Supreme Court and just what kind of, you know, a docket they've had this year. I mean, just so much drama, so much national attention. So I could kind of see them reviewing, okay, tropical storm flooding. You've had a ton of tropical storms this year. New Mexico, the West is on fire, water evaporated. Okay, you guys are just being jerks. Boom, two sentence ruling, we're done. Mm-hmm. You've got two lawyers and a retired state senator who has dealt with water law adjudication. And what I bring to the table is, you know, I'm two thirds water and I drink it. So Southern New Mexico groundwater, whether that will be revisited, typically the Supreme Court doesn't go back to previous rulings. Previous decisions, no, I do know that. What will happen with the groundwater, does this lay precedent? Yes. Mm-hmm. I mean, it will add to the case. So I think, and this has been a hopeful show. You know, we've got the broadband funding, we've got a vaccine. So I'm going to, as someone who is composed of and drinks water, say, yeah, I feel good about it.
There you go. Hey, Laura, let me read you. Justice Brett Kavanaugh delivered the opinion for the court, stating, quote, "This question presented is straightforward. Under the Pecos River Compact, does New Mexico receive delivery credit for the evaporated water, even though that water was not delivered to Texas? The answer is yes." Pretty, you know, anything to parse there? Do you hear anything, any hints of anything else? It seems very straightforward.
It is very straightforward, and I never thought that I would agree with Brett Kavanaugh on anything, but he got correct, and I think the Supreme Court got it right. Of course, people in Texas might disagree about that. You know, I'm a member of the Natural Resources, Energy, and Environment Law section for our state bar, and we have obviously a number of water lawyers, amazing and very successful water lawyers that are a part of that section. So I'm always careful to not wade into their space because I do energy stuff. Mm-hmm. But I will say that, you know, in New Mexico, as I think in the West in general, water is like oil, right? I mean, it's actually much more valuable, yep, to the West than a lot of, you know, the oil reserves that we have, for many reasons. And this is one where I think the basic science made sense. You know, how can you expect a state to deliver a certain number of acre feet when there's obvious evaporation happening? And that's really what had occurred. So it was a straightforward, I think in my mind, a contractual issue that, you know, New Mexico didn't cause those acre feet to evaporate. That was just sort of a, you know, part and parcel of the physics of the entire thing. Mm-hmm. So I think they got that right. What will be interesting, I think, is what Dee Dee brought up, which is the Rio Grande River Compact issue. That one is interesting because it pits, first of all, Colorado and New Mexico against
15 Texas. Seconds, sorry about that.
Mm-hmm. But the issue has to do with the local Elephant Butte Irrigation District farmers who had been using some of that Rio Grande water for their livelihood. Mm-hmm. And Texas then feels like New Mexico should have, you know, given them more than what was taken out. So it's a very interesting local government, kind of local impact issue.
Mm-hmm. Hey, we're out of time. I want to thank our panelists for being here. To all the panelists, have a great holiday. Very safe. Please be sure to catch up with us on Facebook. Just search New Mexico in Focus.